right now. Just gotta carve it up. One of the camps can use this.
Huh?
another Nero micro recorder.
Agent Sinclair reporting. I'm at Corpse Disposal Site 13 Beta, supervising the unloading and disposal of cargo. You never get used to the smell, do you? Trains have been running nonstop, and all the current sites are almost to capacity. I've put in recs to open up more federal land, but the encounters with DC have stopped turning my calls. Yes, they have more important business. Side note to Perkins. I was right, asshole. Yeah, I know we fucked up initially, modding the site here instead of over at Site 13 Alpha, but it worked out, didn't it? You remember I had to argue my ass off to keep this site in our back pocket. I knew it was going to be bad, but no one believed me. I guess you all believe me now.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of
those sample traps. I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not the doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
Where's the text, Carver? I saw something in our crotch. I'm going to check it out.
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant, don't become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, Norman, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Speculation as to Tabanus Atratus is confirmed. Lots of rumors. As if you're about to have the suit on, let me tell you, carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be what a Coroides, Lioness, or Mule Deer. I don't know if anybody can check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of Hulgin strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
Look at it this way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself. Now, whether that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb from goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little spacesuit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember at the rooftop of the old brewery, I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't, please. You don't... Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't going to make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Brian,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Man, a few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look. As soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah. Okay.
O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel, god damn it. Okay, you better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, god damn it, oh, come on, O'Brien! Get back to me.
Track down the chopper. Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah, it was him.
Did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Maybe you can finally, I don't know, find some peace.
I don't need to find any peace, Jesus, Boozer. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.